Hi, I'm Tim, and welcome to WatchYouWant.com. Thanks for logging on. Today, we're looking at 2014's other birthday boy. That's right, for all the hullabaloo surrounding the Patek Philippe 175th anniversary in the year 2014, this year also marks an important anniversary, the 20th, for Lange Söhne of Saxony. The company, based in Glashutte, Germany, was refounded after the fall of the Berlin Wall in 1994 by watch industry legend Gunter Blumlein and the last scion of the original Lange family, Walter Lange. That year, 1994, they debuted a number of models, among them the Lange 1, to restart the ancestral Lange brand. Now, the Lange 1 evolved in 2005 into the watch you see here, the Lange 1 Time Zone. And this watch embodies all of the classic Lange Söhne aesthetic and technical innovations, as well as many of the refinements that have become styling hallmarks of Glashütte watches since the fall of the wall, and many of which have been pioneered by Lange itself. So let's jump straight into the dial, which is the highlight of this watch, at least from a functional standpoint. Lange is known for its asymmetrical dials on the Lange 1, and the Lange 1 time zone is no exception. This watch you see here actually features two time zones, but it's not a traditional dual time, GMT, or even world timer. Actually, the watch that's most similar to this one would be the Jaeger-LeCoultre geographic complication, whereby you have two dials, one of which is cued to a rotating chapter ring with reference cities around the outer circumference. Now I'm going to try to focus in a little bit, and this never works, so I'm just going to hold it a little bit closer and try not to lose the definition. But you can see that as I travel through my time zones, if I want to reset my reference city, or if I just want to see what friends in different part of the world are doing at any given time, dinner, lunch, breakfast, or am I in a nighttime no-go call zone, well, I just move those reference cities around and I put them at the index at 6. And as I move them around, you can see the hour hand on that small second time zone subdial moves around. And it's that simple. I just set my reference city and I can see what time it is there. And there's a little subdial next to that subdial, an arrow pointing at semicircles, light and dark, to tell me whether it's day or night. And the local time zone has the same right here. So you can see whether it's day or night, home and away. It's a fantastically user-friendly, very simple complication, but possibly the most practical of all complications for frequent travelers, those who do business with individuals in far-flung regions, or those who have family far away. Very practical, very helpful, and a real crowd-pleaser. I like to say that this, split-second chronographs, tourbillons, flyback chronographs, they're all great crowd-pleasing complications because they do a lot and it's easily accessible. You press a button, something happens. Surprise and delight whether your audience is into watches or not. A great conversation starter and a lot of fun. But there's more to it. There's a power reserve right here, and the watch does have a 3-day power reserve. I know when a watch has a longer power reserve than 42, 45 hours, I like to have some sort of indicator because there's that luxury of not having to wind your watch every day, but if you don't know exactly the state of wind when you take it off your wrist, you might wind up having to spin it up every once in a while just in case, because it's got two time zones, it's got a grand date, and it's a pain in the butt to reset a watch. So to preserve that convenience of a long power reserve and to have peace of mind, I think it's great that they installed a power reserve indicator, and it helps them to make the most of the asymmetrical real estate on the dial. You've got the second time zone, the primary, the two AM-PM indicators, the power reserve, and the signature Lange Grand Date, or the Big Date. That's something else that the company has made a fixture in the watch industry. Not only is it a signature of the brand, but virtually everyone has copied, every watchmaker, except maybe Rolex, has copied them in putting a grand date on at least one model since the early 90s debut of the Lange 1. Moreover, it's a sign of their heritage in that it's a complication that was more or less inherited from Jaeger-LeCoultre. Gunter Blumlein, one of the principals in refounding Lange, was also a major executive at Jaeger-LeCoultre during the 80s and early 90s. So that's where that little bit of family DNA comes from. But on the case back, you can see Watch You Want, signature. Hide underneath is the good stuff. The Lange L31 movement. Right here, you're looking at what's known as a nickel-silver movement with Streifen. One of the original innovations of Lange in the modern era was to bring back this heritage of fabricating watch movements from the combination of nickel and copper to create what's called German silver, or if you're in a French-speaking region of Switzerland, Maikorf. Now, German silver, of course, is not silver. It actually has a goldish tinge because of the copper content. It's a beautiful golden sort of evolving tone that starts darker than rhodium-plated brass in a Swiss watch, and it darkens over time, becoming more and more like gold as the years go by. Very, very corrosion resistant, actually better than rhodium-plated brass. It's harder to work, which is why few use it, and it's very hard not to scratch it during assembly, but Lange has that down to a science. Not only do they finish it beautifully, but they work with it almost exclusively in their model, or in their models across their line. Now, two of the signature elements, in addition to the material itself, is the use of a three-quarter bridge to cover the dual mainspring barrels of the three-day power reserve. Much like an old pocket watch, the three-quarter bridge gives Lange a lot of real estate to cover with the stripes and the subtle texturing between them. But then everything gets very, very intense as you move towards what's known as the balance cock right here, holding the balance wheel, and also this train bridge, this train cock that sticks out, because both of those are hand-engraved. That's really a lost art in watchmaking. Hand-engraved movements rarely seen. Not only are these absolutely baroque under close magnification, incredibly intricate, but each one sports a unique signature of the artisan who actually carved it. Now, Lange has about five or six full-time movement engravers who make these components for them, and each one has a signature style. And you can, if you have a little handbook from Lange, they actually sell, you can actually figure out who made that part of your watch just by looking at the pattern. Very much a cottage industry, a craft level operation. Lange only makes about 50, well, actually only about 5,000 watches a year at this point. So most of these engravers work from home and then deliver their product to the factory. So when you're making 5,000 watches a year, you can do that. Patek Philippe, which finishes its watches to a very similar standard but in a very different style, they make 50,000 watches a year. So Lange has a very small, warm, family-like approach to building watches. They're a very tight-knit group. It's a small factory, a small operation, and you're really getting the output of just a handful of people who are very focused on their craft. It's a completely different finishing tradition than what you'll find in Geneva. Very endearing. Rare still, even with the recovery of Glashutte watchmaking, it's a completely different character. Now, this watch has a bold wrist presence, although it's not a large watch. I'm going to put it on my wrist so you guys can get a sense of a 6 1/3 inch wrist, 16 centimeters for our metric friends. The watch is a perfect size, I think, for anyone to wear. It has good presence because of the broad dial and the way the gold dial, or the silvered dial with gold elements, flows into the gold bezel and gold case. Very presentable. Big, has presence, but not oversized. Very elegant. This watch, the Lange One Time Zone, is available with full box and papers, all manufacturer accessories, on our website, watchyouwant.com. Check out the high-resolution photography of this superb Lange Söhne handmade dual time zone watch. I'm confident that if you're into something a little bit different, if you want something fine, something special, and you're not afraid to go outside the borders of Switzerland, this Lange One Time Zone just might be the watch you want.